Morning, good evening, good afternoon, good night, whenever watching the video. Welcome back to the channel. So in today's video, I'm going to tell you how you can play as a Kaljor main on this map. First, we will discuss about defending, where you can put your turret and ultimate and all that on B and A side. Then we will talk about attacking. Okay, one of the favorite place which I have for turret placement is this right here. Why is that? I will tell you. Because that turret is stopping from people from coming from here, from entering the site, you will know. And you can always peek from here, whether they are coming or not. And second thing, the turret also stops from people coming from mid, especially from this side. Not from here, but from this side. So that's one way of using a turret as a two-way stoppage. Then you can put your alarm bot here. You can always put your spawn grenade here also, in this pocket. Put your cursor here, right click and spawn grenade. Same goes for here. Cursor here, right click, spawn grenade. So this will stop if you bombard all together, na? People can't enter the other side. Another thing, you can put your spawn grenade here, it will stop from people coming from side also. But there will be some gap here. Same goes for this side. You can do this by throwing, just sticking to a wall and throwing it like this. Sorry, right click. Okay guys, right click will do the job here. Another spawn grenade placement is here. While people are coming here, you can always bombard the spawn grenade if you are here at the back side.
Spawn grenade out.
And this will cover the whole site. But not, they will not be able to enter here for a while, or they will get a high damage. Another place to put your turret will be this place. Why exactly is that? People actually will get hit from this turret. Another turret placement is this. So it's not easy to break your turret from here. You see, it's not that much easy. If people has a, I think, AWP or Vandal, then they can try to wall bang, but it's not easy to kill. And you can always peek from here.
Yeah.
Rest, you can know, there's a, you can use a turret as a backstab right here, or you can use your turret as a backstab right here also. With your alarm bot in the middle. And rest is your creativity, you can put your turret here also, on the wall also, like this. So people are coming from here. It will stop people from coming this side, and people come here and enter the site. It will stop them from here, here, and they will. The turret will also stop from people coming this side. And you, same can be done here also. If you put your turret here, then it will stop people coming from there also and there also. Now the ultimate retaking at B side because you are defending. So put your this turret, make sure that there is no people backstepping. Put your ultimate here and match your mouse line with this. Look up and throw your spawn grenade. And boom, detonate. People standing here will get a damage because that is the only side which is open. From the ultimate, I can show you back here. Put your ultimate here,
my ultimate is ready.
Match it with the cursor and place throw your swarm grenade. Boom, swarm grenade, and they are damaged. And second place, you can use your ultimate is here. You can also use this while taking the site with this right here, but you need to defend it. Because people can come, so only this area will be open, so you can easily enter the site and kill people from here. So that was for attacking at B site and retaking the B site. So in mid, you can always put your turret here, so it will stop people from coming there. It will also stop people coming from mid.
Here.
People will coming from mid, they will get attacked by a turret. so you will know they are coming. Same this turret placement you can use in your attacking also at B side. Put your turret, if you stick turret to your wall like this, then the turret will only hit people coming from mid. And if some people is coming here to kill you, then from this side like a backstab, so the turret will stop them and you will know they are coming. And if you want this area of the people to be also be covered with your turret, you need to put it a little bit open, so this will actually allow them also to hit your turret. So be careful, they can easily break your turret if you are not careful.
Bot coming back.
Another place you can put your turret while attacking B or saving bees on the wall, but this turret will be easily be breaked, so be careful if people are watching there. There is another turret placement in the mid which you can use in attacking, is by putting your turret here. So this turret will keep an eye in the middle and a backstep, and from here only you can put your turret on the wall also. So if your turret survives, then people peeking from here will get damage, mid also, and from this side also. This turret placement is the best if it doesn't get destroyed so easily. Okay, I think if I stick to it from the wall here, maybe it works. That's why I have not tried. So yeah, it's take care of the mid. It's stop people coming from here, and it also stop people who are coming from here. Okay, so you can use this in defending also. And one thing of this advantage about this turret is that the range drain, you can see, you can also enter the site and then also your turret will be there in your range at B side. So it's a very good advantage. A side, this is my favorite place to use a turret, which is this. So it's not fully open also, people can't shoot it from this side easily. As you can see, it's a metal box. This turret actually has a range from this side. So people entering from cave, A side cave, will get damage from your turret. And people coming from mid will get damage from your turret by this turret placement. Another turret placement is this. So here people coming from cave will take damage, and people coming from mid will probably see your turret here if they are not busy peeking at you, so they will get damaged by a turret. Now the best placement for a turret they don't actually know about is this. For this you have to stand here and not jump, middle, whatever these are called, and jump. Simple. So this turret will actually stop people coming in from mid, and also this turret will stop people coming from here on the side. But one thing is that this turret will be easily be breakable if people coming up from cave. So there's one disadvantage. Another thing, when you have entered the site like this and there's no one here, then it's better to put your turret here on this one. Why is that? I will let you know. So you have planted your spike here. Okay, you have planted your spike here. Now what will happen is this turret will stop people coming from here. It will also stop people coming from here. Okay, most of them who are coming from mid, they cannot easily break your turret. So when they are rotating here, they will see your turret and they get damage. So you can always use that as an advantage instead of putting a turret here. So these are the two creative ways you can put your turret here. Another thing, as you know, turret can pass from doors. So, and this door is indestructible. So voila, turret inside the door. For this you need to actually put your turret properly in the center or it will not work. And like this your turret is hidden pretty much. It will clear this save also, it will save here also, it will save here also. Your whole A site is covered. And regarding ultimate, so in retaking the side A, you can use your ultimate here. So this will cover the whole area and there will be a gap at the A side, and people cannot actually break your ultimate so easily, so it's not easy to break. Second location where you can use your ultimate is here in this tunnel. discounter. So people will came outside from backsides from here and here, so you can easily kill them. And second thing, you can always open a door and kill people from here. They will be lurking here also. These are two ultimate spots which you can use, and third one is this one. If you're coming from it, use the ultimate here. It will cover almost the whole area, part of the cave. Mostly people will be here at the back side, so you can kill all. Now regarding your swarm grenades, if you use your right click of swarm grenade and throw them at the back like this, then they will fall here. So this swarm grenade trick works on all sides. Just don't use your right throw, use your left throw. Right click. See. Right click. Right click. Stick to it and throw a right click. Stick to it and throw it a right click. One swarm grenade trick is to, when you are at A side, throw one swarm grenade here. So this will stop people coming at you from peeking from here, and they don't know there is a swarm grenade hiding here. Bonus thing, here in the tunnel, they are having a secret meeting and they have a grenade. This girl. And this same squirrel can be found on the other end of the map. See. And this time there is a fourth person, which is this penguin. Yeah. So one more thing is that you can also use a storm grenade here also. Same right click. And if you throw it properly, then it will land here. And this keeps the door open all the time. Another place to hide a storm grenade at B is this. Here. This keeps us from getting hidden from people, and you can also stop them from planting here. That will show. So this cover the whole side of this side. Same type of storm grenade can be thrown here also. And with this, I think I've covered every turret placement which I can think of and use in attacking and defending. It's up to you, by the way, how imaginative you want to be. And with this, I'm ending the video. Like, video, subscribe, and thank you for watching. Bye.